Hey, Monkey fans! Zopher here, returning to what hopefully is the final installment of the Banner Saga. As I said, I took care of getting supplies and leveling people up. So now we are going straight to the docks. The last place we left at, we had just arrived at Borsgard, and now we're prepping for the final battle. When you get to the docks, your heart sinks. Not a long ship to be seen, aside from wrecks. Bodies float in the water. Buildings are trashed and boarded up. What happened here? Murmurs Alette.
They're all gone, says Ivan, approaching alone. I see you had the same thought as me.
Ivan, you're okay.
I'm fine. It wasn't a lie. The governor is here. He's in hiding.
Why?
Since the dredge started appearing, anyone with a ship and a half a wit left a long time ago. People can't leave by foot. Food is scarce. The markets are bare. Borsgard is a fire cake waiting for someone to tip it over.
So the governor's paying the ravens to protect him against his own people?
And keep the peace, so to speak. It's more like a massacre anytime there's a hint of an uprising.
Where does that leave us?
I promised him the Mender's protection in Aberang. I don't think he's very popular there. They're going to start tearing this place down to build new ships. We can ride the Ormsa River all the way to the capital.
Leaving another perfectly good city behind? How long will it take to build new ships?
Hold on, what happens to the people living in Borsgard?
It's the best I could do, Alette. He thought it could take as long as a month. You don't usually make ships out of scrap lumber. As soon as people figure out what's going on, there's going to be riots in the streets.
A month? Why bother? Bella will be here in a week, if not sooner.
I'm open to suggestions.
Gods be damned, is there no end to this?
Ivor roars in frustration, leaving you standing by the docks. Alette gives you a worried look before chasing after him.
Ivan,
what do we do about Bellower?
Ivan says nothing for a moment.
I don't know.
Well, great! So, let's get our stuff going.
Hooray! Alright. Let us talk with Mr. Ivor, since that's all we can do. You find Ivor standing on the city walls, overlooking the fields outside. Dredge are keeping their distance, but continue to gather. Man, we're all sad faced too.
I'm okay, Rook.
Ivor cuts you off before you can say anything. You know he's been through worse.
Just feels like someone should cut us a break every now and then. If we want to be standing a month from now, we're going to have to be prepared.
What do you have in mind? First off, our clansmen need a place to stay. They'll get torn out to pieces in the streets. I'll keep an eye on the dredge up here. If they break through the walls, we're done for, so we'll have to keep them back. Could always use a hand with that. We know who's controlling what and make sure we get our cut. Food's going to become scarce. And when they start building those ships, we're going to have to keep people away. What a damn mess. I'll do what I can. Ivor explains, I'm leading attacks with Ivan every time the dredge get too close to the gates. Listen, we're going to lose fighters in Varl every day like this. I don't need to tell you what happens if nobody is manning this wall. We could always use help. Alright, well, first things first, I'm gonna find a safe place for my caravan because I brought these people from Skogr. I want to make sure they're safe. The entire caravan is spread out in the streets where they're attracting attention. We could look for a public house, suggests Alette, like Frostfeller. You figure that if you made camp in the open, you could at least keep everyone together. Or with people leaving the city recently, there might be abandoned houses you could squat in. I'm going to go in the public rest house. Most of the caravan convenes in a large rest house that is nearly empty. The owner tells you people are either afraid to go out in the streets or have already left the city, and they've been attacked a number of times for any valuables. But your people are all welcome to stay if they wish. I'm going to leave some fighters, because it's risky. So, you take volunteers to keep watch at the rest house, which the owners are thankful for. Hopefully they won't be missed on the wall, but you feel better knowing that your clansmen will be relatively safe. So we lose 20 fighters, but, you know, they're safe, so that's good. Minus 14 Varl. Alright. Let's talk with Ivor! Ivor points out the dredge along the wall. There's a lot more of them, and they're getting braver, he says. We lost a fair amount of fighters since yesterday. We could use your help. If there's nobody left to defend the walls, one of your clansmen from the caravan finds you. Just wanted to tell you that everything seems to be fine, he says, regarding the people in the caravan. There was a little scuffle with some looters, but the fighters you left sorted it all out. Sweet! Renown!
Yes!
Leveling up. Will likely take a full day. I'm gonna join Ivor in defending the walls. Yes. We've been a little more aggressive lately, says Ivor. With their numbers going up, they don't take us seriously unless we're taking out two for every one we lose. So, I'm gonna help out. Oh, nuts. I must have touched that. Let's see here. Crumrear Rook, Ivind. Alright. Let us. Wait, what's Rook wearing? What is Rook wearing? Oh, he's wearing that. Okay. I thought somebody was wearing that. Nobody's wearing the Bjarkin rune? What does this do? Sorry, I'm like really not sure what I want to give people. So you can get that. Crumrear, you can wear that. That's cool. I don't want aggro going to him. Plus two strength. I mean, why not? Why not, right? Like, it doesn't matter, because he's not getting hit. He's the only one that can wear it, so let's roll with this. Let's wreck some dredge, guys. Look at all those big eyes. Okay, so I want to move. He's... Alright, let's do it. Get that armor knocked down. I don't want to deal with that shit. He's a little weak. I could get Crumrear over here. Alright. That might be bad for Crumrear, but we'll make it work. So. Let's mark prey. That might help me out a lot more. Yep. That looks good. I didn't need that armor anyway. Let's do the Rain of Arrows and just see if anybody gets close enough to mess with us. Alright. There we go. That'll be helpful. go. Oh, yes! That's awesome! That was fucking awesome! That's the first time that worked. Alright, so... let's... go... and... instead of attacking, I will... oh, wait, shit. I guess I do have to attack. Alright, that's cool. There we go! Armor down... let's get that strength knocked down so he can't do as much damage. Crumber is gonna take some hits here. Alright. Get Ivan to mend that armor back up. How much will that do? Two. Okay. So that does two. Oh, he missed. That sucks. Knock down that armor a bit. That helps knock his armor down a bit. Ruck. I could go here and maybe kill him. Yeah, let's do that. Ruck prey. Let's try that out. I did a lot there. He was full health, so I guess I should accept that. Ow, I did take that hit though. That was not pleasant. Oh, she can kill this guy, so I'll do that. I want to see who that hurts. Let's try it. Guts! So it did hurt Ivor a bit. So it does hurt the guy who that stands next to you. That is good to know for the future. Wait, that one hurt. And... there we go. Could this be our first match where nobody goes down? That would be impressive. Maybe not, because I am still alive. Yes!
gutso on him. Sorry, Ivan. Let's try it. Yes! Something had to give. This might hurt. Alright. Can Echo make it? Can. Echo! Wreck his shit. Yes! So we did not lose a single person that time. Oh! We are great. Oh man, and we get all that renown, and we don't have to, like, no one's gonna go into battle hurt next time. Oh my god, it's so great! Alright. This is bad, says Ivan, as Ivor points across the battlefield. Aside from the fact that we're up to our necks in dredge, a stone singer showed up. If we don't deal with it, this wall will come down by the end of the day. Dad, there's a riot at the docks. Alette runs up to you out of breath. They're trying to smash up the boats. When you calm her down, she says the ravens are there, but she's worried that things could get out of hand. Let's see here. Ooh. I guess we will join Ivor in defending the wall. If we don't take care of it, Ivor tells you, this will be a rough fight, but we've got to take it down. You ready? Yeah. I can promote Rook. I can promote Oddleaf. I can promote Echol. I will promote... I'll have to use 15 or it'll be 20. I'll promote Rook so he's at level level 5 and has enough going for him. Maybe I'll give him more armor. I'll give him a little more armor. That should be enough. That should work. Okay. And Ivor, Crummer, Rook, Oddleaf, Heckle, Ivan. Okay. So let us start the battle. Yeah, it's a lot of battles back to back. So, okay, this doesn't look too bad. I mean, we got that stone singer. Like, he's so far away. All right. We can get this. All right, Crummer. Ivan, you back up him, and there. Okay, I like that. Alright, so I need to just get forward, and then kill this guy.
There we go. Cool, I'm right up next to the Stone Singer. Oh, cool. And we can just wreck the Stone Singer. There we go. Oh, God, Crumrer. Crumrer, it was worth it, buddy. Wait, is he a... What is he at? Is he a 5 or 6? I can't tell! What the? What is this shit number? Come on. All right, it's 5, I guess. 7. Shit, man. All right, Odd. You can do this. 90%. Survey says, yes! We took him down. All right. Okay, Echol. I'm gonna move here, and you're gonna guts it out. Oh, that one's huge. And, like, I can't heal from there, so... Arc Lightning. Use it on him. He needs to lose some health. Yeah, I knew Crumrer would go down. I need him so that other guys can get hurt. Ooh, that sucks. Done. One big guy left. Resisted it. Sweet. Can't help. I hope that doesn't hit, Echol. Nope. Cool. Hell. Oh, I should probably move from there if those are gonna explode on me, right? Okay. What does battery mean? Gonna be summoning some douchebags to help him out. Okay. I need to kill this guy. Just right off the bat. Damn it! Got him! Yeah. I can do for him.
Ah, damn it, he did get a summon in.
That's okay.
Eccle, stand strong! Oh, you can't guts your way out of this.
It's only 50% chance. That's an 80% chance.
Like those odds. Fuck.
We got the renown though, so that's good. Oh my god! Look at this. Look at how they're all like getting closer and closer. Just look at all of them. Look at all the dredge, and then they got their weird dredge priests and whatnot. Oh my. This morning, I saw him. Bello is here. I think it won't be long now. Ivan leans silently on his staff nearby. You consider what you want to do now, knowing that any of these tasks will likely take a full day. Find a source for supplies. Track down the ravens. Let's hear. Checked around. Nobody has food, or they won't part for a fair price. They're either gouging the prices or just plain gone. See what they know. You find the massive leader of the ravens along the docks, where they're doing best to keep a growing number of people in check while the boats are being constructed. You question about the food supplies. Should have brought your own, he says. I can't go giving it out to every person in Borsgard. I'd kill every last bastard in this city for some good mead, though. This place has been dry for weeks. Hey, we happen to have some awesome mead from Reykjavik. Let me get this straight. You happen to come through Reykjavik with Sigbjorn in tow and plenty of mead to go around. Is that right? You hesitate a little too long. I'll murder that murderless lox, growls Bulverk. As he turns to leave, he grumbles, bring the barrels and we'll make a trade. The caravan protests when you tell him the deal you made, but when you return with more supplies than you expected, the complaints vanish.
Sweet.
We have enough to last us forever. Alright. Ivor, can we really keep this up? Ivor looks like he hasn't slept in days. We lost a lot of fighters, he mumbles. The situation is crushing. Then from far in the distance, you hear a horn. Dredge don't use horns, it occurs to you. Ivan appears at your side just as a long caravan of people come to view, Dredge turning to attack them. Who is that, you ask? It can't be, says Ivan. He runs towards the gate, shouting. You see their banner? It's Hakon! As you wonder how they got here, the gates are heaved open, and you charge in the field, clearing a path through Dredge. Oh boy, more Dredge! Alright, Crummer's injured. Gonna... Oh, I wanted Sigbjorn. Okay. Do I want to use an injured Kremrir? Okay. By the way, I believe 5 is the highest level. Yeah, you can only get to level 5. So... Oh, I don't have enough to promote! Hogan, can he be Hogan could be promoted. So... But do I want to? I don't want to promote Hogan. So... I'll just roll with it. It's been going good so far. I'll just keep it going. They can come my way if they want me so bad. Also, we have all of our will, so that's good. Alright. Come on! Let's get this going. Alright, and because I am not a stoop, I know he can shoot arrows! Oh, I can't believe it took me that long to realize that. Uh-oh. Okay. Let's see if anyone comes that way. I don't think so, but we shall see. Echo, I think that you'll do better in there. Okay, so no one's coming that way. Ivan can come here. Try and see what we can do. See how injured we can get these guys looking. I don't want that douche coming at me, but... Right, we'll do it this way. Oh, no! Man! So I need to go, like, the whole way to do that. Although I don't like the idea of this too much. I do not like this idea too much, but we'll make this work out. Okay, and that's enough to kill him! Good job, Rook! Oh, damn, because she shot her arrow. Whoops! 90%! Survey says... No! Damn. Nuts. I should have left a little path for that. Wait there. Oh. hope it bounces from him to the other guy. Should! Oh, well, I'll take that. Damn! That was quite useful. That was way quite useful. Now. Unlikely, but I might. He'll hit. Yeah. Whatever. It was good enough. Good enough to get the job done, I think. Dead. So now all we got are a bunch of slingers, which are annoying as fuck. I'd rather just do Cool. Eckle got another kill under his belt. I think we only lost Crumrer, so that's good. And we got 10 renown, which will allow me to level up some people.
Juno. I wasn't sure I'd ever see you again, Ivan.
She smiles and they embrace. Ivan is completely taken aback, as though he doesn't dare believe she's real. I'm sorry I couldn't make it to Sigerholm. I ran into problems.
Problems is putting it lightly. There's a mile-wide canyon practically splitting the world into two over those hills. Couldn't find a place to cross. Worse, Dredger practically falling out of it like blood from a wound. They're not coming from the north anymore. They're everywhere. We noticed. Glad to see you made it out alive, Ingvar. I take it the others didn't?
Hakon becomes quiet, then he motions towards Juno.
She got across somehow. Found her out cold for a second time since leaving Strand.
We need every axe we can get right now. Bellower is here.
Gods be damned! I thought I was free of that menace.
I will deal with Bellower.
Come on, no need to tempt him by standing out here.
Sweet.
Hakon's caravan enters the city, fighting off waves of dredge as they go. To your relief, hundreds of skilled warriors are now safely in Borsgard. Hakon joins you with his personal bodyguard, Mooger, behind him the Prince Luden and his entourage are in tow, though looking less than pleased to be here.
I have one last trip to make. I need this one to come with me, she says, pointing to you. I'm sorry, Ivan. You must wait for me one last time. Do not let the city fall before I return. It takes everything within Ivan's power to hold back, but he does. She turns to you. Ruk, come with me. We'll return in 2 days, maybe less if we're as quick as you look. Tell anyone who needs to know.
Where? Why? Not far, says Juno. She pauses and something shifts in your vision. For just a moment.
I know it's hard, she says, her voice filling your head. And you've already been through a lot.
As she speaks again, the rest of the world melts away. But you're needed. You can't find the words to argue.
Ooh, buddy. Hoodalolly.
Oh, man. This is frightening. Look at all of them. You don't remember leaving the city, but you are walking through unfamiliar ground behind Juno. You're alone, aside from hundreds of dredge who are all facing toward an enormous stone ahead. The hairs on the back of your neck stand up.
Wow, look at all of them. It's like some kind of worship, you know.
Just standing there. I like how you have a tiny cart. Like, why are we bringing a cart? You know? Ooh, another godstone. They're like, it's like a fucking cult over there. Jesus.
We're at the Godstone of Straws.
You glance nervously around, but the dredge didn't seem to hear her.
It's okay. You can speak softly.
Is this where you're going to sacrifice me?
Juno smiles. What could have come across as profoundly creepy looks sincere instead.
No, the dredge cannot see us. To be more precise, they can see us, but I've convinced them to be unconcerned. I can understand your apprehension, though.
Who are you?
I wish we'd had time for a proper introduction. My name is Juno. I am on the Mender Council. You've met Ivan, my apprentice.
How are you doing these things? Controlling minds? I thought Menders built things and healed wounds.
You are right. Menders do these things. Some of us still practice the teachings given to the Loom Mother's first creations. We are called Valka. I believe I am the only one who can influence another's mind.
Then why not take control of Bellower?
I learned the talent to heal minds, not control them, though even some Valka have trouble believing this. Taking control of Bellower, it is the difference between convincing a child to sit still and telling a starving bear to stop being hungry. The truth is, we're rarely a match for the Sunder anymore. Our advantage is that we can train more Valka.
It is also our weakness. The Valka pass on and lose their knowledge, while the Sander simply grow older and more powerful. Bellower is both immortal and beyond my influence, to a point. Then how do we stop him? The God of Secrets will play a part, as will you. What are we doing out here? Do you know the God Straves? Few know this stone exists, even amongst those who have lived their whole lives in Borsgard. While Dengler deals in fortune, Stravis taught men the value of trade in a different way. He showed them it has consequence. Two sides of the same coin. See the silver in the stone? The gales up here wear away the stone, but the metal remains. We need a piece of this silver. The god Stravis is wreathed by imagery of silver weapons. The myths say he traded these weapons to the gods, and they use them to kill each other. Those who seek out the stone call him the god of trade. The menders call him the god of secrets. He was both. Why are we surrounded by dredge? They seem to be drawn to the godstone. There are many things we don't know about Straves. Maybe they see him as a patron, or it is an attraction they cannot explain. Does Stravis have something to do with the serpent in Einartoft? What was that thing? I cannot say. Can't? I have my suspicions, but until I've had time at the Mender Libraries, it would be unwise to speculate. For all our knowledge, it always seems as though we know little. Imagine how the rest of us feel. On the contrary, the less people know, the more certain they tend to be. Why did you pick me? Why didn't you take Ivan or Hakon? You don't even know me. I apologize for putting you in danger. Ivan must keep Borsgard from falling while we are away. And if anything goes wrong here, I need to be certain one of us makes it back alive. I saw the thoughts of each person when I arrived at Borsgard. You were the only one I knew would return. What do you mean? You would find your way back to Alette, no matter what. Let's get what we need and go. Indeed, you'll need to dislodge at least a fistful of the metal. We will forge it into an arrow to slay Bellower. Wait, after everything you've told me? Make a magic arrow to shoot Bellower. That's all it takes. Why didn't you do that a long time ago? Juno gets a faraway look in her eyes. No, that is not all it takes. What I tell you now must not be repeated. The arrow will not kill Bellower. Even were it to strike his heart, he has no physical weaknesses, but it will sow doubt in his mind. When it pierces him, I will help him to believe that he is dying. The rest of you will convince him of it with sword and axe. Everyone who fights at your side must believe it is true. You're going to trick him into thinking he's dead. That is the most insane. He really can't be killed? No. Someday he will awaken and realize he's not dead. I imagine he will be quite upset. First, we must make the arrow. Focus on the task at hand. She looks knowingly at the godstone, waiting for you to start climbing. Rook, I am not certain how the dredge will react when you do this. And behind us is a sudden drop. So be careful.
Awesome! This is a really cool scene. Like, I just absolutely love this scene. I mean, so ominous, so impressive. Like, you guys just have to witness it on your own when they're your players. I know you've gotten involved in my story, but it's, you know, your story will just be as immense. And the end. Woo, my god. I am not looking forward to that. Real tearjerker. Approaching the back of the stone, you start to climb, looking for a loose piece of the silver vein. Even without looking out onto the dredge, you can feel each sinister face watching you closely, held back only by Juno's influence. Panic races through your blood. Let's see here. Climb higher where it might be easy to remove. As you climb, you can't help but notice the stony masks of Dritch lined up before the godstone like worshippers before an idol. Just a glimpse nearly immobilizes you. Your hand rests on a piece of silver that comes away easily. The Dredge do not react. Don't press your luck.
Don't fuck with the gods!
If we've learned one thing, don't fuck with the gods. You nimbly descend to where Juno is waiting. Well done, she says, as you walk back through the Dredge, their heads turned in unison to follow. Creepy. I mean, seriously, like that, like... God! Ugh. The dread that lingers in the shaking of your hands does not subside for hours.
Ooh.
Man. That's rough. You approach the gates of Borsgard again, relieved that they're still standing. It looks like they took a beating while you were gone. Alette rushes to your side and throws her arms around you once you've crept through the gates. Juno smiles at the reunion and tells you, take this time with your daughter. Find a smith who can fashion an arrow from that silver. I have other things to which I must attend, but meet me on the walls when you are done. All right. Let's go to the crafters. It takes a while, but you finally find someone willing to craft an arrow for you. He eyes you suspiciously when you show him the silver, but shakes his head and gets started. Alette watches, the smith's fire reflecting in her distant stare. I talked with Eivind a long time while you were gone. He told me a lot about Juno. Is she really as powerful as he said? It certainly seems that way. That might be the most luck we've had so far. Dad, I think I know what's going to happen now. An arrow. She's going to make you shoot Bellower, isn't she? I don't know for sure. Come on, who else is going to do it? Ivar? Alette, I know where this is going. You're afraid of me dying. This isn't like before. We can't run this time. That's not what I... Let me do it. What? What? Why not? Because you think I'll get hurt? What do you do when Bellower comes straight for the person holding the only thing that can destroy him? Let me speak. Everything's changed. Skogr feels so long ago. I'm not asking because I'm afraid of losing you. I'm not afraid of anything anymore. Let me do it because you know I'm a better shot. I have a better chance of puncturing his armor. We only have one shot. I'm not a child anymore. I'm not just some girl. I'm your daughter. I can do this. For once, let me decide what happens to me.
Whew. Wow.
That is some heavy shit. All right, guys. So this is what I'm looking at right now. Do I take the shot because I don't want anything to happen to my daughter? Because I don't want to put her in harm's way? Or do I let her take that shot because she is a better shot, like, because it would be recognizing that she is important to this whole process and that she's the one that needs to do this for her. I mean, like, when I first played through this game, my whole thought process to this was, you can't keep your children safe 100% of the time. You have to be willing to, you know, take that risk that they could get hurt so that they can grow as people. And, like, I wouldn't want to hold any child of mine back from, you know, from doing what they know that they can do.
So, with that in mind, I'm going to let her take the shot. You know, because you don't know if it's going to turn out good or bad. And if it turns out good, and if it turns out bad because you didn't let her take the shot, that's bad. But if it turns out good, regardless of whether she took the shot out, like, it's... You would never know. Like, you'd never know that she would be safe. So, you gotta let her take that risk. You gotta take that risk. You know, you gotta let her grow up. So, I'm gonna let her grow up. She smiles and takes your hand in hers. We'll survive this. I know we will. You sit by her side silently until the smith finishes his work.
Oh, man.
Alright, so... I'm gonna level up some people, because we got a bunch of renown, and we need to use some of this renown. So, Alette's gotta be in it. Alette has only killed one dredge, so she's still rocking that level 1 nature, but that's okay. Ivor will be in that party. Ekel and Odd I'll have in the party. Irsa. Oh, I would love to have Irsa there. And I can promote her. So that's good. So I'll promote Irsa. I will give her more chances to use Flame Arrow. So she'll be level 3. Ekel. Do I want it to be Ekel or do I want it to be Hakon? I can promote Hakon. I think I want Hakon more than Ekel. Because I think that he would be a better choice for this. I really do. So, okay. Confirm that. Alright. And then 20. Oh, I got this! The Statue of the Sightless Man. And here's what I've done. And I will do promote Oddleaf. Right? Everyone else is 5. That I can get to 5. Yeah, Hakon, I can't move up. So, Oddleaf. I'll promote her. Yep. And get that going. There we go. Okay. Man, I could promote her again, too. I could have got her to 5. Let's see here. What does this one do? +3 armor break. Oh, no, wait. I'll give that to Ivor. Because dodge strength attacks and +2 strength. And then I'll give this to Hakon because he's 4. Which works out great for me. Irsa can have... the Silver Brooch. And Alette's just gonna have to sit back because I need that. Yeah. I will give Alette her bracelet. Why not? +2 strength resist, +2 drawing aggro. He draws aggro anyway. It'll keep these guys alive longer. And that'll help out. I hope. Alright, so... We got plenty of supply. I mean, there's really nothing else to do. It's
this is the final battle. I'm pretty sure this is it, so let's get this done. There he is. Juno is in the middle of an animated debate as you approach, the arrow in your hand. There is little time left. Bellower knows we're here. Whether he is waiting for more of his forces to arrive or simply wants to starve us out first, I cannot tell. But he will not expect a direct attack.
Is this a joke? How are we going to do that?
I will take a handful of warriors to face him. I can keep a small group hidden from sight. The rest of you will lead the charge from here. With luck, Bellower will send his armies away from himself to meet you.
What about the ravens? They must protest.
They will not. I've arranged a task for them.
Even if you make it to Bellower, what chance is there of defeating him? We saw what happened at Einartoft. That thing can't be killed.
Juno shows them the arrow you had forged from the Godstone Silver. This will make him bleed like the rest of us. Once he is pierced, he will be vulnerable. She looks you in the eyes. We only have one. Do not miss. And bring only those you absolutely need. It will take all my concentration to keep the other dredge from swallowing us up. I cannot join in battle.
And if we kill Bellower, then what? The dredge will just wander away?
That is my belief, yes. I can't say for certain.
This is a doom plan! Help us hold out here until the ships are finished!
And then what? Bellower will hound our every step all the way to Abrang, where I am certain more Sunder await. Now is the time to speak to loved ones, and the memory of any god that pleases you. Rest. In the morning, we slay Asunder. Whew. It's good, because I think I need to switch my party up a little bit. I didn't put the... Oh my god! Look at that. Bellower. It's like, are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? And the answer is no. Of course, I'm never going to be ready for this. But we're going to do it anyway. The silence is what you remember. You rise in silence and walk through empty streets. Upon the wall, two armies stand quietly, watching each other. Your footsteps echo on the wooden floorboards as you approach Juno. She breaks the silence. It is time, Juno says. Gather your allies. Today one thing will end, another will begin, and our actions will decide on which side we stand. Oh, man. This is a shit fight. I hate this fight. Oh, I love it, though. I hate it, but I love it. All right. Alette goes last, but I need because I need her. All right. We will see how many times I have to do this. Hopefully just the one. Okay, now I believe... Okay, so... Still your fearless and I will try to guide you. Okay. Alright, so we need to... We just need to make a freaking march to Bellower. If he can make it, I'm gonna take that shot. Oh, and he can kill him instantly! Yes! Damn, that sucks. Oh yeah, we're gonna take damage every fucking turn. I need to get up to him. The arrow cannot be used until his armor is broken. So we're gonna break some armor. This lag burn won't work just yet. Alright. I believe anytime I kill any one of these guys, he's gonna screech and it's gonna suck. Alright, so you go. I just gotta get these guys out. Oh crap! Could I have taken Ivan? I don't remember. Well, if I fuck this up, I will check. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, by the way, if you use the... This is our new power, Silver Arrow. Only possible when chance dead is 100%. So we have to knock his armor down, hit him, and then the second part of the battle happens. So move here. So we need to knock his armor down. Let's knock him back. Did knock his health down. Keep the archers safe. Yeah, thanks. Thanks. I didn't think of that before, but now that you mention it, it is nice, isn't it, to keep the archers safe and all. I can move there. Elor got hit. He's gonna screech and like go hurt. Alright, so slag and burn. Slag and burn. That knocked a little bit of his armor down, which is good, because we need to do that. Big guys out of the way so my Varl can move into position. She won't have much to do. Yeah, that hurts. That sucks. Stunned! Fuck me. Kill this guy. So now that the big guys are done, the strategy becomes knock Bellower out. So, right, so now it becomes we need to get Bellower's armor as low as possible and ignore these guys. Attention. Oh, damn! Is he dead already? Oh my god. He is dead. He is so dead. Oh, fuck. That sucks. Alright. Let's see if Bellower moves at all. I probably didn't want to do that. Socks! Oh, I might have fucked this. Oh, goddamn. He's down, too. He's down. Fuck. He regenerates one up turn, too. So. Back up to 16. Shit. This is fucked up. Ah, damn it, I lost. I'm gonna have to try this again. Yep! Yup! Gonna have to try it again! Cause I don't have enough firepower to get him down like that. I can't kill his armor enough. See, look, he's already maxed out again. Like, damn it! Damn it! To fucking hell! I don't know what to do. I really don't. Because he's just gonna hit me. Like, I can't, there's no way. Like, I just don't have enough left, because he's gonna come here and he's gonna hit me. And that's it. Fuck! Fuck. So does anyhow, blah, 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 blah. Fuck me! All right, we'll try it again. Try it again. Can I take Ivan? I can't take Ivan. So, who's gonna do me better? Is Irsa or Oddleaf gonna do me better? Irsa. Irsa, I think, does me better. Alright, let's try this again. See if we can get this done. Alright, dup dup. We know. Okay. How are we gonna do this? How are we gonna do this, guys? Wait for them to come to us. Let's try that. I am going to rest. Alright, see? Now this is better. Already it's better. Knock us back in a second. So. Wait, Ivan. My starting move is gonna be the next time I start. It just sucks! just sucks because I had such a good starting play, but now it's all fucky. Especially now that a Hakon's gonna die right here. Resisted. That's good. Rook's turn. I'm gonna mark him. No, because I think I can knock him down. I could have probably used her. Man, I'm just making a lot of dumb mistakes. Like, a lot of dumb mistakes. And honestly not feeling very good about it. Like, see, if I'd have just used a Let there, I mean, I guess I gotta go through an entire, like, round of Bellower's gonna go next. Now I can take the shot, but he's gonna. See, this sucks! Because she goes after him. So, like, what the fuck am I gonna do? You know? Man. Okay, that's fine, that's fine. Ah! Man. Alright, what's his armor up to? That much? I don't care as long as Alette gets to take the shot. Once that happens, then we're okay. Alright, so he gets to go here. Break his armor. There we go. His armor's broke. I don't care if these guys die right now because... Yeah! Silver arrow time! Yes! Oh! He did not like that. He did not like that. Oh no, Alette! Yeah, I knew this was gonna happen. This was so sad. Like, so sad the first time I saw it. I was like, oh. Like, oh, it was terrible. It gets sadder, too. I mean, defeating evil was never meant to be easy. Everyone's... Alette, no! Please help her! Okay. So, haste, Rook, finish Bellower now. So, these guys. See, we're all back to full health and stuff. Well, as full health as we can get. But we only have four. Sucks. We'll do that. Ivor. That's scattered. Shit, I need somebody to get in front of Bellower. I need to not. I need to start knocking Bellower out. Can I attack anyone? Nope. Okay. Can I mend from this far away? Oh, I totally can. Skull! Oh shit, that's gonna hurt. A lot! Like, all of the hurt. Enough to get up there too. Awesome. Can I do three? I can. I need to get that armor down as much as possible before I die. Before I get my ass killed. That's fine. Like a douche. Oh, serious face. Alette, no, not her. Where are the menders? Rook, she is beyond their help. Stand up. You're only barely aware of the surrounding chaos as Dredge flee from Varl warriors who push their advantage. Bellower is dead. You are not. We must go. Let me carry Alette to Borisgard. We'll honor her properly. Juno was right. With Bellower fallen, the Dredge flee the field of battle. You return to Borisgard, but have almost no memory of doing so, aside from the image of Alette's still body being carried in Ivor's arms. Let's go talk to him. So, we should have the time we need to finish the ships.
I think you're right. The Dredge don't seem interested in us anymore. Since Bellower fell, they've been going their own way.
The Ravens have been keeping the docks clear. Juno's talking to them about something now. When those longships are ready, we'll be able to sail all the way to Aberang. With luck, before the darkness shows up here. How far south has it spread? I couldn't say. Hopefully not far. We'll get the prince back to his home, and Hakon has already decided to come with us.
There's not much else to go back to. The two look up as you approach. Rook, it's time. Soon we'll be ready to leave Borisgard. Find somewhere safe. One ship is done already, at the docks. I had it prepared for Alette. I'm not ready to see this. Come, Rook, it's time to honor your daughter.
Oh, man.
so sad. I mean, this is what you said. I was saying, you know, like, you can't always keep your child safe, and like, it would suck. Like, Rook's gotta just be feeling like shit right now. But this is cool. But it, you also have to be proud, because she knew the risks and she took that chance. And like, she didn't die. She lived until she couldn't live anymore. And that's all anyone can ever ask for. This game is just so great. This scene is perfect. Like, just hits it all, you know. I mean, it's like that whole, you know, traveling to the afterlife, you know, and look at what she has before her, you know. God, those trees are so pretty. But, I mean, Alette saved everyone. She was the one who made it so that Bellower could be killed. And so many more people will be thankful for her for doing that. Hey, look, I finally beat normal difficulty. And I got Quartermaster. That's the achievement you get for not running out of supplies. So awesome, I got two achievements out of this. Oh, beautiful. Austin Wintery, fantastic job with the music. You are great. I love it. There definitely will be links below for that. The animation, you guys, great team. The art inspiration, Ivan Early. Man. Oh, Lord. So, this is just great. I can't talk enough about this game. Like, just buy it, play it. It goes on sale so often, which is such a bonus for games these days when they do that. I mean, shit, just buy the set. Even if you don't like games like this, just buy the soundtrack to listen to. You know, get it for your parents or something. I'm sure they'll love it. But, it sucks that it leaves off on, like, it's not really a cliffhanger. I mean, it's not like some games where they just leave you off hanging. I mean, I want more. I want more of the story. I want to see how this darkness, I want to see what the snake has to do. I want to see all of these things, but the story completed. The story was about defeating Bellower and finding these characters and getting to Aberrang. And like, now they'll be able to get to Aberrang. It'll be interesting to see in the second game. I just recently got it, so I will be playing that very soon. Like, it'll be coming up right after this one. I can't wait to see which characters return. I can't wait to see. I hope some of my favorite. I hope Eccles in there. I doubt it, because like, games like this, they normally don't put characters in if they could die. But then again, because it's not a true RPG, it's a tactical based game. Like, it's just a character model. So hopefully everyone who could possibly be in it will do it. I'll definitely give this another playthrough. I'll do it with Eggle Lives. I mean, I want to see the different stories. I want to see the different arcing paths. So my next playthrough,
I'll probably have Egil live. I'll probably have Alette live. By the way, if you do the other thing, Rook dies. Look at all these Kickstarter guys. I wish I had known about this game before the Kickstarter came out, because I would have definitely Kickstarted this. I'm glad that they didn't need to kickstart the second one, that their sales were good enough that they could just go with it. I'm glad to see them succeed. I think all the best for this company. Their name eludes me now, but I mean, it's not difficult to look at. I mean, it'll be listed below, you know, special thanks and all that to them. I mean, it's probably passed by here, or will pass by here in a second. I don't know. Overall, this is one of my favorite games of all time. I mean, for an RPG to keep playing it over and over again, I really like the way that they did combat. That is so great for me. It's annoying, but it's annoying in a good way, you know? I don't even know, like, I don't know what to say. Like, what do you guys saw me play it. Like, it's pretty awesome. Let's see here. Some of my favorite characters in this. I mean, obviously Egil. I just love his character. Like, he's crazy. Like, it's crazy characters are fun. I love the crazy characters. Rook, like, it's, you know, like, watching Alette die is a little hard for me, because Rook, I think, is supposed to be, like, the character you project yourself onto. And, like, and, you know, I projected myself onto the character of Rook, and, you know, like, you know, his struggles were my struggles, and I try to play it like I would play if I was him. You know, and, like, oddly, you know, like, so many tragic figures, you know, Oddleaf losing her husband, losing her village, you know, but finding you at the same time, but then also losing Alette. Let's see here. Who else? I'm trying to think. I mean, I like Luden. I mean, I really like the characters that are kind of, you know, dicks, pretty much. You know, like, Luden, he's cool. Is that Moog? Or no, it's not Moger. That's not who I'm thinking of. I'm thinking of the... Crumrer. Yeah, Crumrer. Crumrer is fucking glorious. I'm glad he's still going strong. I didn't really get into Hakon as a character as much as I would have liked. I mean, I know some people will be able to get into him, because he's, like, just the big, strong, tough guy, you know? Like, the guys that like to play as, you know, the generic soldier character, you know, just the smash kind of guy, as we used to say in D&D. Like, they'll like Hakon, but that's not me, you know? I mean, Rook is pretty much, you know, like, if I was designing a character for this game, you know, because there are no character customizations or anything like that, it would probably actually be Rook. So probably that's why I fit into it so well. Let's see. There's so many characters. It'd be interesting to see if Sigbjorn shows up. I've seen it in some of the marketing material that, Bjarvik, what the guy, the Varl with the black hair that's in charge of the Ravens, he's been in promotional material for Banner Saga 2, so it's likely that he'll be there for. It's likely that he'll be there as a playable character next time, which I'm looking forward to. Otherwise the story, again, like I said, you know, the dredged baby, I want that to make an appearance. I want to see a good dredge. I want a dredge on my team. Like, I want that. I'm the kind of guy that, you know, like, I always like when the bad guys aren't really all that bad trope. You know, I like to have, you know, like your orcs and your goblins, you know, be there that, you know, you wouldn't expect to be the good guys. So I'd like to, that to show up. Let's see here. I mean, I don't know what else to say. I'm kind of rambling, you know, there's a lot of freaking people following, you know. I actually might cut some of this out. I might add like splice this to the end. So if you want to hear my, you know, comments or whatever, I don't know what I'll do with it. I'll see. I'll test run it and see what people want to do. But I mean, I've seen some really cool things. Apparently there'll be centaurs in the second one. So that'll be interesting. I want to know where they're going with that. Other than that, I have honestly, I have no idea what the second game's going to be about. I mean, I assume we'll be fighting more dredge. I assume there'll be different enemies for us to fight. I assume we'll get crazier characters. I hope that the ones that they choose to have in the game are the ones I like, but I know everyone's different. Maybe next game I'll figure out how to use Warhawks properly, since I just can't. They're just not strong enough. They're big and they're varl, but they're not strong. They don't take hits. Yeah, they can hit everyone in a circle, but if you're surrounded as a Warhawk, you're pretty much fucked anyway. So what's the point? So, I don't know. I guess I will, I don't want to do a disservice to the people who kickstarted this, you know, so I will probably, you know, speed this up or something, or maybe I'll just cut it out. Like, I can't see this. I mean, we're only on the D's or something now. Like, this will take forever to do. So, guys, I apologize if there was just a weird jump there, because I'm, you know, I just want to make this as easy for you to watch as possible. But I think we've had enough Banner Saga for today, if you can ever have enough. So, thank you guys for watching this. It was a huge blast to play this for you. As always, like, subscribe, follow, send comments, you know, tell me what you like, what you didn't like about it. Give me some suggestions for future games, you know, I always love to see that. And I guess I'll just catch you guys later. I hope to hear, I'll see you guys. Peace out, everyone. Bye.